To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Kelly Anderson. I have 5 kids in the district, and I'm really talking to you today about our transition from 7th grade, and I actually had a great conversation today with Kate, so I almost didn't come in, but I thought I'd throw it at you guys. So my second child going into Marshwood Middle School. My first child seemed to have an easy time going through things, and I think she's a pretty exceptional student, so I think that kind of helps her. My second child going through 2 weeks into the transition, meltdown, complete and utter emotional meltdown with being overwhelmed. And that's the best way I can describe it, is just overwhelmed with workload, homework, multiple classes a night, quizzes, tests, like just freaking out about, you know, the day-to-day and not really feeling comfortable with how she is organized with getting through that. So we've been working on that together. And I'm really confident, honestly, that she's going to get through that and it's going to be okay. But, you know, I see what we're doing here at Rollinsburg. I feel like we're way over here, and I look and see at the very, very traditional Marshwood of quizzes, tests, homework is way over here. And I'm not here to say one place is doing it great and one is awful. It's just different. And I feel like our kids in 6th grade, we need to have some sort of overlap so that first intro into 7th grade isn't so overwhelming and kind of terrifying. She, you know, really was, you know, cried a couple times about things. And the more I've talked to parents about it, and I did throw it out there on Facebook because that's the person I am, but a lot of other parents have told me the same thing, that, you know, their kids are struggling. And I've had some parents from previous years tell me the same thing. But they, in a positive way, they all have said to me, once they get through it, it's all okay, you know? So, you know, is what we're doing here, is it a disservice to our kids, you know, throwing them into 7th grade? And I guess that's my thought right now is, would it be better for our kids to have them start Marshwood in 6th grade? And, you know, I don't know if that is the answer or not. I know that we're doing things to work together with Marshwood right now in this school so that they are better acquainted with what's going on over there. I do know that. But I don't know, it's a thought for all of you guys, and I know, you know, very quickly running the numbers in my head that financially I'm pretty sure it's not a good, great thing for our town, but, you know, at least I can throw it out there for us to think about.
Thank you. We appreciate your bringing that to us. Thank you. Other comments by visitors?
Yes, I'm Donna Brand, my husband Scott. And we're here to talk about, or to just announce, I guess, that we intend to have a student from Germany staying with us and beginning school next September, and we were told to come. So I'm not sure when that, you know, I see that there's something here about payment of tuition for exchange students. Will we talk about that then? about this particular?
Yes, it is on the agenda, so we will discuss it then.
Okay.
This is a time for comment, and since you're here, we'll invite you into our discussion at that time.
Okay.
If that's all right.
Good, thank you.
All right, any other comments, buddy?
Joan Elwood Carnes, I'm a selectman in the town of Rollinsford, also on the rec committee. I just wanted to ask you for future planning, when you guys are planning for next summer's renovations, if you could make sure that we have the gym and one classroom. And as soon as you guys know if that will happen or won't happen, that would be great for our budgeting purposes. Because without a classroom this year was...
I didn't see you.
It's all right.
If you could get me a classroom, that would be great.
That's my very best.
I looked up at the board, and I'm like, I don't see Kate.
She disappeared. Wait, I know she's here.
Right? Let's keep the comments at the board.
Sorry.
let's just try to follow a process here.
Sorry. So that would be very helpful for our budgeting purposes, and just what we can offer to the kids. So you guys did so much renovation in the summer this year. It looks amazing, by the way. But it was quite the struggle, making sure the smart board didn't get ruined while they were playing basketball and so forth. So if you could fit that into the coordination, that would be awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other comments by his ears? All right, seeing no more comments, we will move on. All right, so the consent calendar consists of our minutes from our September 14th meeting, the email from the Department of Education about when they're doing the visit for the school approval, which is an annual event, I believe.
Or we haven't had it in years. It's a random, I think it's pretty random.
Event. Okay, so the random event that happened. The Rollinsford Grade School October newsletter and the enrollment. I know that I would like to pull out enrollment. I do have a question on enrollment. So I know I would like to pull that out. Is there anything else people would like to pull out for discussion? All right, then I'll just pull enrollment out and put it under discussion item. It'll be 5.4. And so we'll entertain a motion then to approve the consent calendar minus the enrollment.
And to approve the consent calendar without the enrollment.
Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Announcements. Well, I have a couple announcements. One is that I think most of you here already know, but you may not, that the town has hired a new full-time road agent. His name is George Gilmet. He started the 9th, so that was just, I believe that was just this week, right?
Tuesday.
Just Tuesday, and actually select board member Jody Carnes has been the one who's been shepherding him through and doing a great job with that. So this is also to let the school know, obviously you probably, if you haven't, please meet him, or you know, get that wonderful relationship going that you had with the last road agent, that'd be great. And if anyone knows anyone with a commercial driver's license, the town is, are you still looking for?
Yes, we are.
Please make that announcement now.
Yes, the town is still in need of CDL drivers for plowing. The three that were here last year were not returning, and we were not made aware of that until when the road agent left. So we are still in need of CDL drivers. We raised the fee, so quite an incentive. But yes, if you know anybody with CDL that wants some part-time work, send them our way.
All right, thank you. That's George. And the other announcement, again, I think many people already know this, but Dr. Brown has let the SAU board know that she will not be seeking the full-time position, the permanent position that will start next year. So I'm letting everyone know the superintendent search is open and in process at this moment. we can never know what the future is going to hold, but in the present, I would like to note that Dr. Brown's competence and professional guidance is already appreciated by me and I believe the rest of the board. So, and we plan to take full advantage of you of your time here. So we thank you for it. So
thank you. Just I might have,
yes, please do.
I have loved working with you, not that I won't continue, but I really enjoy coming to Rollinswood. You're a great board. I love the fact that you're kids focused and that's what your conversations are about. For those in the audience, I'm commuting an hour and 45 minutes each way, and it's a long drive, and it really has taken a toll. I do have a place here in Gonick where I overnight chaotically, but I do look forward to being closer to home again. So thank you, Judy. It's very kind of you to say that.
We're going to work you hard. All we have. Any other announcements? Okay. Discussion items, the principal update, and thank you for the thorough update, Kate. This is a great, I think October is a great time to get sort of this sort of full update of where things are, what you've already found. Great. So, do you have anything to add now that we were sent something? Did everyone get a chance to read it?
Yes.
Does anyone have, do you want to make comments, Kate, or do you want people to see if anyone else hears comments or questions?
The only change would be enrollment for kindergarten. There's 24 kindergarten students as of today, which has changed every day, I think, with the past week. So,
yeah, it's up since ours.
It's not a misprint. It's a nice change. Last Thursday, so I just wanted to be aware of that. The biggest piece, I think, for us right now is communication, and has been for a couple of years, and we're continuing to kind of work out the kinks in that. The feedback about the weekly newsletters and Facebook has been really positive, and it's doing a couple of things. It's giving us a chance to frequently check in about the academic work that's going on, and parents having more frequent conversations at home because they feel more in the know about what their kids are learning at that moment, but also being able to celebrate really easily without having kind of just open the doors of the school to families. So it's been really good feedback about that, so we're happy about that. Movement in that direction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very handy. That's the positive.
Any other questions or comments from the board on the update?
I think reading this highlighted for me how humanly flexible the staff is with all the changes. And kind of to the comments earlier, I read this and I see the adjustments that are being made to help with the transition from sixth to seventh grade, and just in general to always constantly improve the education for the kids, and I really appreciate it. Great.
I do have one question. I know that we've made great strides in math, and to get them ready for math. How do we measure how well that's working, or is there a way to measure how well that's working? Is it just anecdotal, or are there other indicators?
So I think that we just adopted math investigations, so we're not going to really have. I mean, we'll have a baseline that we're getting this year, and then you'll look at it in 3 years and 5 years, and that will give you what longitudinally if it's having an impact. One of the biggest things that we've done is it's by grade level now, so kindergarten rather than the multi-age math approach. And part of that is because there are a number of strands as we moved towards Common Core, I'll save that for another time, but as we moved in that direction, there were strands in math that really became obvious that they were really appropriate in sixth grade and not developmentally appropriate in fifth grade. And so in order to make sure sixth graders had enough time with those to really dive in, we made that adjustment. And we had seven of our 24 kids in advanced placement for seventh grade math. So, I mean, I disagree fundamentally with leveling math. However, our kids are doing very well with their math understanding and knowledge. So, I longitudinally we won't know for a while, but I mean, that is data that shows our kids.
That's definitely a measure. That's the type of thing I was wondering if you had. That's great.
We'll have beginning of the year and end of the year assessments for this year, but we'll be looking at what happens over time.
But I think, yeah, but I think the measure of they're going into seventh grade in a whole new system, that they're a whole new school system, as Kelly was pointing out, and we're able to be in advanced placement in our classes. That's a good measure. So congratulations on getting that going. All right, thank you. I know you have to leave us at some point, so thank you very much.
I'd like seven.
Okay. Looks like Noah is not with us this evening, so Bailey? Make up your name.
Fine.
Okay.
We're packed, so. All right, so Student Council has put on a spirit week this week. Tomorrow is our last day. We'll be celebrating our Blue and White Day. It's a time where everyone wears blue and white in school. And we finish it off with our annual spirit rally, which is another spirit, or another student council put on event. And we also have penny wars that are benefiting the victims of Hurricane Harvey. So during all lunches, we'll be putting out buckets. And if you put pennies in your class's bucket, you get points. And then if you put any silver or dollar, it like subtracts points, and that goes towards spirit week points as well. So you can get a winner. Youth is hosting the homecoming dance, which is on Saturday from 7 to 10. National Honor Society has our induction next Tuesday, October 17th at 7:30 p.m. in Mulligan's Grill at the high school. We're inducting 14 new members. It's a really, really good looking group, so we're very excited for that. And we've also been having donation bins all around, like sporting fest and everything like that. We're having one at the homecoming football game on Friday, and that will also benefit the victims of Hurricane Harvey. We're actually in direct contact with schools from victims of Hurricane Harvey, so we know exactly what they need and where the money that we're raising will be going to, which is nice. As far as classes go, we're all participating in Pumpkin Fest, which is this Saturday from 10 to 4 in downtown Summersworth. Other than that, our freshman class is just having fundraising plans, just kind of keep their momentum going to raise funds. The sophomore class is planning open gyms and game night fundraisers, also kind of getting their funds up for prom and everything like that. The junior class is picking their prom theme. They have a date and a location and everything, and they're also doing a Yankee Candle fundraiser, which is ending tomorrow. And the senior class is looking at senior banquet venues. We're also doing a mixed bag catalog fundraiser, and we're hosting the Halloween dance on October 28th. The Interact Club is selling Halloween grams all of next week, which will be sent out right on Halloween. And as for sports, we have our football homecoming game against Campbell tomorrow night at 7. It's supposed to be a really good game. Our team is 5-0, and then Campbell is also 5-0, so they're both really undefeated, really good teams. So it's going to be a really good game. I really don't understand football, so I'm sorry. Campbell. And then field hockey has our homecoming also tomorrow at 4:30 against Sauhegan. The last time we played them, we tied, so we're hoping to. I play
field hockey,
so I understand.
That's hard to understand. So Scout Weekend is a long ways off.
Yeah, the last time
I played this one, how do they travel? They play field hockey these days.
It was an hour and a half. Yeah.
Okay.
So.
Well, Kelly, thank you for your. I'll just go to Kelly. You're talking about Kelly.
I
know.
Yeah.
Bailey, thank you.
Yeah,
for as usual. And as usual, you are welcome to stay. But I know you were very busy.
Yeah, I keep up prepared for Spirit Rally, so.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, that sounds like fun. And I added enrollment as the last discussion item there. So I have a question on enrollment as I looked at it. And I already gave Dr. Brown a heads up on this week so we can get an answer on this. It looks like we gained a student in Summersworth. And so, since that is something that we were not aware of, we just wanted to get an answer. In fact, if we really did gain the students.
I think from what I've understood, it's a student who was there for half the year. Is that correct, Marie, that they're leaving in? They were away, and they have come back. And so they'll be here until January. Is that correct?
They were here last year.
Here being where?
In Summersworth.
Okay.
And
living in Rollinsford, attending Summersworth.
That's right, they were enrolled in Summersworth. And then there was some misunderstanding. It was understood that they weren't coming back, but they showed up and went to school. So the first enrollment we had, that student wasn't there because it was September.
We had 11 students.
What?
We had 11
right.
Students.
So that student on the next enrollment sheet, so I had to do some research, you're going to see 11.5 because they're not going to be here all year.
Okay.
And they're only here, I'm saying here, they're only in summer's work 50% of the day. So it's everything that can be programmed. So that's how that happened.
Okay. It was a bit of a surprise because we had had 11 students in that class.
I know.
Going back to last year.
So remember that we have certain students could stay in the district until they're 24.
That is correct.
So.
Oh, and do they get lumped into the 12th grade? We don't know. All right. And then thank you very much. That's enough of an explanation.
Okay.
Well done. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. We have no action items this evening. So that's true, right? No action items. All right, the financial update, budget. Now we are talking about our current year's budget. And again, I'd like to thank Marie for pulling out the warrant articles so we can see exactly where they fit in from last March's balloting where they now fit into the current year's budget. So it's very good to see them there. Thank you. I have probably asked this question 6,000 times, and I really am going to try to remember the answer this time. Other support services, which is line,
which is line 2900.
I believe what you always say is go look at the detail, which I didn't do.
And that tells you what that is.
Okay.
There's reimbursement, workshop reimbursement.
Okay.
There's the work unemployment. Compensation, and there's workers' comp, and then there's the grant state Medicaid too. So when we contract out to get Medicaid reimbursement, and that's if they charge the fee. So when they submit, you get the revenue, but there's a fee attached to it. So that's what the fee is.
Thank you. I should have gone. I've now written in big letters, look at the details.
How come it's called other support services in one spot and other benefits in the other? Does it matter?
On the 2900?
Yeah, 2900 and on the first page there. This is the first page. It's called other support services, but then on the detail it's called other benefits.
We can change that.
I don't think it matters. I was curious if there was a reason.
We can change that. It's just a system thing. We change it. Thank you.
No, but it's an inconsistency, so sometimes it makes us think about it.
I had a question on page one. You broke out the maintenance of the grounds, all the warrant articles. Is that 45,000?
Yes, for the
Where is that on our warrant? I see the 40.
That was what was originally budgeted, just the regular maintenance one.
That was approved budget.
That was the approved budget.
Okay.
And then we had two warrant articles.
Warrant articles 7 and 8 should be.
No, it should be 7 and 8.
Okay, fair enough. Okay.
Just to show us what the. And I believe, I know we asked the question last time, and I'm going to assume the answer is the same, that the reason that all of tuition isn't encumbered yet is that we haven't gotten all the final figures from Marshwood yet, correct? That's like really how many students.
Well, we know how many students, but there are other services that need to include in the
other. That are included in regular.
No, not regular.
Well, it's regular education where they're not on.
They're not in either place in the regular world.
Okay, so
we just want to make sure we're captioning the right.
Okay, and once we do, we will encumber. Okay, all right. Other other questions? Any other comments on budget? All right. This is probably, I don't know if this fits under budget or not, but I did have a couple other questions on in general. And I know that Dr. Brown is going to follow up with Dr. Nash on the 50-50 custody tuition item, and also on the tiered sped costing as a way to look at another way for us to cost out sped between. Do you have an update on either of those?
I do. Dr. Nash said that she was very open to sharing that tuition if we have that set of circumstances. Mm-hmm. And then we're meeting with Dr. Nash and her staff on Thursday. We did have a conversation about the tiered services. She said she needed to think about that and needed to run costs and numbers. But she was very interested. She said she could see why that would be a benefit to both parties. Mm-hmm. So,
that's great.
Yes. Well, that's great. I mean, thank you for bringing the suggestion. You'll keep us informed as to how that...
I will. I think what she's looking at is not a tiered approach, but a program approach, comparable to what we do if you place a student in an out-of-district placement. Mm-hmm. So, for example, if you had a resource room student, you might have a program cost for that, as opposed to a self-contained student, and there might be different costs. Mm-hmm. So that's some of the research that they were going to do. Hopefully we'll have an update tomorrow. Thursday, a week from today.
Someday.
A week from today.
So we'll hear about it at our next meeting. But it's interesting. Anything I think that saves time is also going to save both districts money, obviously, and maybe easier for all of us to understand.
Yeah, I think it will definitely be easier to understand. It will help budgeting, and I think for my staff and the superintendent's office, the hours spent going over those bills, and it also created some friction between the two. I think that would be set aside if you had just a classroom and it was.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Keep those cookies coming. All right, moving on to new business, the Primax contract renewal. Do you want to? It's not really, because we're in a two-year agreement, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
I thought that was going to come off, but yeah.
Yep. All right, so just to remind everybody, we have a two-year agreement, three-year agreement with Primax, where they guarantee that it will not go up more than 9%. That's the maximum our premiums will go up under Primax. And they are our workers' comp and liability, property liability.
When do we know when?
Well, we can budget what they said. I think the poppy is 9% and the unemployment is 7%. We should be getting the numbers fully. If we don't under budget the 9 or 7. The 9% for an increase of 9% for property and 7 for workers' comp. And I'll adjust it when we get the rent. But we should get it fully. We sort of the final budget.
They usually let you know.
Oh, yeah, they give us numbers. They tell us what the premiums are.
Any other questions on that? No, it shouldn't have been on here. Okay. Anyway. All right. Now under old business, we're getting into the community connections, and Aaron was kind enough to share the first FAQ, which is on the activity bus, the late bus. I thought it's a very nice. I thought it was very thorough. Really answered a lot of the questions that people have out there. What are other people's thoughts?
We've kind of been in
a group effort.
Well, Erin really is the driving force, but we all gave her input on that.
Yeah, I think it's good. It will be helpful to answer those questions for people.
So let's talk a little bit about how is that something we can just get out there? I mean, get out in public. How do we get it out in public? We can place it on our Facebook. The school board has a Facebook page, which only pushes information out, right? Do we want to also get it on the town website, on the SAU website? What do we want?
I think it would be great to put it on the SAU website under the Rollinsford info, and as we get more of them, because that's the plan, we could have an
section of the Rawlinsburg area.
Yeah, so is that possible to have a, you know, FAQ, just, you know, maybe a school board FAQ? We need to have it show that it's from the school board, right? How do we want that labeled on the SE website? Do we know? Any suggestions?
School board FAQ, please.
And
it could just be one page with links to PDFs of the FAQs.
Sure.
Can you send that to us? We can put it up.
Mm-hmm.
And perhaps we want to see if we can post it down the town and other places. I mean, this particular FAQ is more pertinent to people that have children, students, but in the future we may have other.
Many people in town would like to be interested in the cost. That, you know, the difference in cost was so amazing. And again, I looked up, and the price of that $20,000 for the door-to-door service goes up each year because I looked at the bus contract, it's like every year it went up because they charge us per bus. Any bus that goes out, that's what it costs to send out a new bus for a student. Marshwood is just charging us however many miles they're charging us to get the kids over here.
So, do we want to put it on, or see if we can put it on the Rawlinsburg Town website, or do we just maybe have a blog sent out, ask Tia, she'll send it out through the town blog and link to the page on the school from the SAU site? What do you guys think?
I think that's great. I would love to get a couple more there before we publicize it. It's kind of silly to just have one and think, sending people, like, maybe three, at least, to get rolling.
But as soon as we can actually get it on the website,
sure.
It's not publicizing, is what you're saying. Right?
Yeah.
I mean, we can put on Facebook, et cetera,
right.
But, I would say,
and then people will maybe remember,
I should go see if there are any.
Yeah, we can start by putting it on the school board.
So what are other, the late activity bus was a huge topic. What other topics do we want to try to get?
Transition to, middle high school transition. We can develop it the same way. I'm sure they're probably, the same questions each year or so.
That's true.
Some things, but that's how it's going to be tagged. Because people are searching for stuff, like transportation bus, late bus, however they're going to be able to pick it up. I don't know the answer to that, how we would do that, but it would seem that if they could search it, if they have a question, how do they get right to the late bus? I have to admit, it's in the past at least, that SAU website is not the most user-friendly thing. It's hard to find stuff. If you're a parent, you don't use that website a lot, you don't necessarily know where everything is. So how can we highlight and make it a little easier for people to reach those sections? Because it's going to be an issue, and people are going to want to find an answer.
So to have somehow, I've been trying to write the Rawlinsburg School Board FAQ thing be pretty well visible right from the front, from Rawlinsburg. So
we don't want anybody to come and say, I wasn't able to do this. It was, we don't want to.
That's never going to happen, let me assure you.
Okay.
I said, that will never happen. It doesn't matter what you do, trust me. I like your idea about the transition, though.
We don't have to, that could have to be a thousand things, but
totally.
There might be common themes people are kind of wondering.
Perhaps we could talk to Kate about, maybe we could find out the things that they are doing to help with the transition. And some of this information that she gave to us in this report.
Well, I'd like to ask you all a question. This is supposed to be a school board FAQ. And we don't know all the things that are happening as far as transition. And so should it be from the school board? Kate said she's doing a lot more communication.
I think it should. Because we're the ones that are sending out the survey. It's not the school that's sending it, it's we're sending out the survey.
So things that we have gleaned from the survey would be in there, not things that the school
was. Some of the things that we're seeing, what are the common groups, what are the hot buttons, you know, pain points, what are the terminal needs? Just the things that people are most frequently asking about. It could be about transportation. And we can highlight, you know, or have sort of a link to the other, you know, see this section. There's a lot of unknowns. I just think that we all went through it. Our kids that have already gone through the transition and, you know, sort of a learn as you go. But I think that this will be a good area, you know, where the school board can provide a quick area, just like what they did with the bus, the late bus.
What would you tell someone who has a student who's at stake, having been through it, something like that, those types of things?
Absolutely. Things, you know, I'm trying to think of something.
The reason I'm asking the question is...
The gun to my head, I'll come up with 1,000 different things, but there's a lot of
things. But the reason I'm asking the question is, it's one thing for you to talk parent to parent, it's another thing for the board to be saying, this is our official answer. Right. So I just want to make sure that we're not confusing the two.
Well, I just think there are a lot of questions, you know, and I think a lot of parents at Rollinsford Grade School, sixth grader parents in particular, perhaps that are wondering and maybe don't know and aren't asking what is being done to help with this transition. We are here, so we are hearing from Kate. They are working with the teachers there at Marshwood. You know, they're meeting, they're discussing things, they're taking steps. Math is now being taught grade level, you know. Mm-hmm. So there are things that are being done here. I don't think all parents are aware that it's on the radar.
And again, I'm just going to say, it's not our job to say what's happening educationally within the building.
Right.
I just want to make sure that we don't want to cross a line. And I think it's great that we have four parents on the board who actually know some of the, you know, and that we get the principal update and hear these things. But maybe we need to direct Kate to be pushing more of that information out.
This is true.
Or direct Dr. Brown to direct Kate to push that information. So I'm just throwing that out. Emily,
thank you.
Sorry.
I would recommend that we do put out something on the transition, but instead of answering questions about what the RGS is doing with Marshwood and all that, we answer questions like, how do you find out about sports? Step up day, orientation night. You know, those kinds of things, where you're going to get your information, because those are things that have specific answers. It's a pretty black and white process. You know, if your child is interested in, you know, playing a fall sport, you should get an email, you know, in the beginning of August, giving you a link to tell you, right? Like, those kinds of things, I think, are things we can answer. I think we need to be careful about answering those kind of softer edge questions. I don't feel like I would be comfortable.
Yeah, I agree with that too. I mean, you know, we don't want to become like, you know, Dear Tom.
Yeah, right.
Well, that's a plug. No, and I don't think I want to answer completely for what's happening here,
But I do think there are a lot of questions related to the transition that we can answer, and it would be helpful for our parents to have a quick glance at, like, oh, this is what we can expect.
And also, sort of like one-stop shopping for links, emails, where do I go, who do I talk to, about whatever, you know, that kind of stuff. So that way they won't go to one site and they'll be able to see.
I think that sounds good, and I'm just going to throw out one other suggestion. We use the word transition all over the place, and we're not sure if it means, well, these 3 years that it's taking us all to get there, or what it is. Do we want to call entering Marshwood Middle School? Do we want to call it something a little bit more about, what the, you know, more FAQs on entering Marshwood Middle School? I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm just throwing that out as a suggestion.
Yes.
You guys come up with really good ideas.
I agree.
So there's one suggestion. Sounds like any others, quick ones?
So, and I don't know if this is a boundary issue too, but I keep thinking of one about work? What are we even talking about? What's missing? Why are we so concerned about it? I'll definitely need some help with that one in terms of getting the facts right, but I think it's a confusing issue.
It's definitely a confusing issue, and I think that once we have a collective bargaining agreement, that would be the time to start, you know, to lay out the background and what we're doing.
Okay.
That just seems like a better time.
Okay.
But just to me, it does.
But
I
don't know.
We can answer what,
can answer
the,
what the issue is. That's true.
What, you know, why are there steps? Why, you know, what? Just, I mean, I speak that. Just those basics. Until I was on the school board, I did not understand them.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I still have questions.
Well, I think that, so that is a good one to start looking into, and we'll get as much help as we need from, you know, from administrators and to lay something out there and get something started on that. Other suggestions? Those are a couple good ones.
Well, then I guess after the classifying is done, perhaps, you know, I don't know, as a, I guess we want to keep it as a FAQ, so. Would we have questions about that, you know?
Right. Maybe that's a good way to kind of set the pace for that kind of.
Because we can always have a little, you know, please send me questions.
Yeah, sure.
Get me questions for you.
Well, maybe that too. Maybe we put that out there. There's, you know.
Because they might be our frequently asked questions, but it might not be. We want to make sure we're answering their frequently. All right, anything further on that? Good stuff. All right, thank you. Marshall contract items again. Did you have a chance to find that folder? Marshall contract items. We started a list last year.
Oh.
And there should be a folder somewhere in your office.
We need to watch the movie National Treasure.
I apologize for putting you on the spot.
No,
this is
okay. There is a folder, but I don't see with the contract in it, and it looks like iterations of it, but no list.
Okay. That's right, but yeah, we can go back to the minutes and find them. And all right. I mean, there weren't many, but we'd like to make sure that wherever it is we had already identified, we haven't lost.
Okay. So. We'll look for that.
Thank you.
Probably the minutes is a better place to go.
And as we get closer to it next year, we'll deal with it then. So, but we want to make sure we don't lose it. Thank you. Any update on the late start time, Marshall?
I have not heard of any further meetings.
And so our last one is sort of the payment of tuition for exchange students. We have the folks here to talk about this a little bit. We discussed this, I believe. We had a discussion last year that some of us will remember about. And again, there was a couple who wanted to have an exchange student and it came to us and said, "How does this work? You know, they're going to go to Marshwood." And we had a board discussion at the time and came to the conclusion then that while we all 100% agree that this is one of the best things that can happen in any high school to have foreign exchange students there, that it's a lot to ask the community to pay the tuition when it's a tuition student to do that. And as a board, we did not feel that we could just do that, to ask them to pay that amount of money. The value of having an exchange student is great, but it really accrues to the high school. Mm-hmm. It does not necessarily accrue to the community. Mm-hmm. And
And it's very difficult. It's a difficult call. It's a difficult call.
We had hoped as well that Marshwood High School would, you know, they do have students that would come as exchange students, so our hope was that they would take that on, but here's the thing.
Hence the Marshwood contract items to discuss with them. It will be something that we will be bringing up in our next, finding a way that maybe they could find a place in it to sort of accept. If we had a high school, it would not be an issue. Mm-hmm. We don't. Mm-hmm. So
do I understand it correctly then? It hasn't been determined yet? You know, if we do go ahead and have a student living with us and attending Marshwood, would his family pay tuition? Has that been determined that's definitely the case?
He would. It is our understanding that that Marshwood will require tuition to be paid.
Okay. And so, who would be the contact person for this young student's parents if they have questions and they want to work out some things like that? Or
I assume it would start with Dr. Nash, wouldn't you?
Yes,
say?
That's correct.
Okay.
So the superintendent of schools.
Okay.
And since it is not under a tuition agreement, It's possible, and I'm just I don't know this, so I probably shouldn't even be saying it. So maybe, well, I'll say it anyway. We had students who, before we had a tuition agreement, their parents paid to send them to Marshwood, mm-hmm. so that they would be starting in ninth grade or starting in sixth grade or seventh grade. The state tuition is the tuition they can charge just a private citizen, not a school district that is sending all their students there, is often lower than what we as a town would have to pay.
I see.
So I'm just letting you know that. Okay. And I don't know if that's still the case. The state of Maine sets that for them. So.
Is Dr. Nash over in Marshwood?
She's the superintendent of schools at Marshwood. Mm-hmm. And
could we go talk to her, do you think?
I think that would be the next step if it were going to be a private tuition setup.
Okay.
Good. Thank you.
And really, and I understand you hosted the student's mother, did you say?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
It's really wonderful.
She was 16 at the time. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. She has four kids now.
That's great.
It's wonderful that you wanted to have her children have that experience, and with you.
Yeah, we couldn't have imagined the relationship that two of our sons went over and stayed with them, visiting, and she's come seven or eight times. Her parents came, and we, Scott and I, just went over to visit them about a year ago. So,
that's great.
It was a real success.
It's absolutely wonderful, and we do appreciate that folks like you come to us and keep it in front of us, because we do want to try to work something out with you so we can accommodate this as we move forward. So
thank you very much.
Any other? All right, future meetings. There are a couple of Marshwood School Board meetings, October 18th, November 1st. Our next Rollinsford School Board meeting is the 9th of November, and we have an SAU budget. We have the school board meeting at 6:30, but at 5:30 we have a budget.
On the 9th.
That's correct, isn't it? Mm-hmm. We do it, but I'm pretty sure.
Yes.
And we have an SAU budget workshop at 6:30. On the 13th. Anything else that we're missing on dates? And then it's Thanksgiving. And there are no school events listed, so there's no one here to. I understand the kindergarten's having a bake sale tomorrow, so.
No bake sale.
The corn maze, video corn maze, is, I believe, next Wednesday.
Well, I'm sorry, did you say that?
The corn maze, the PTO is hosting the corn maze out at Zach's farm as a fundraiser, and that's next Wednesday evening.
We're trying to coordinate flyers out as possible to that.
No. Any other meetings that anyone, even in the public wants to mention while we're running the meeting? All right, that's the meeting, school events. Closing comments by visitors.
Celia Leopold, Washington Street, Rollinsford. I'm not sure you can answer this, but I'm going to run it by you anyway. With the kindergarten enrollment up, how many students in that class before the class has to be split?
Yeah, we're not going to answer that now until we get to that point. This is a large kindergarten class, but it just became a large kindergarten class in the last, since last Friday when we got our enrollment. There are more in there now than there were when we got our enrollment sheet. So we are the school, Kate and Superintendent Brown are keeping a close eye on these things and working closely with our kindergarten teacher. So
I was just wondering if there was a magic number or if there was a plan in place if something, if it were to grow exponentially over the next couple of months.
I'm sure kindergarten parents will be kept informed as that goes along.
And in relations to your community questions or connections, FAQ, it would be really nice. This is the first year I've been involved in anything related to the school. So I've turned to the town website many times. I've not seen your SAU website. So if you're going to put something out, it would be good to maybe put it on the school website, get a special tab on the school website that says school board, and then you could put it under there.
If I could just point to, on the town website, under schools, there is New Hampshire SAU 56 is a link under schools. So that's from the town website, you click on schools, and then you click on New Hampshire. And so it is there. I mean, you can get there from the town website. Is that what you're asking?
Yes, but I'm thinking if you're going to put it out there, you might want to just put a blurb on the town website to let people know. Because if you're just putting it on your website, people are not going to know to go to your website.
Yeah, that was part of our discussion this evening, but thank you. Yes.
And that putting it on the town website and in an email blast to the town would promote your community connections with those people not involved in the school, is how I feel personally. And I'm sure there's people that are retired that want to know what's going on because their money is helping fund this place. And as a parent, there are two things that pop into my head, and I don't know if you have any say in these matters that you could work into FAQs for the future. And I'm fairly new at this, so I don't know if they're already there or not either. Is that the curriculum and what, as a school board, what you expect of the kids to be learning throughout their career, or what model of curriculum we're using. And then, because I get stuff home from the teachers and the principal, but it's not over the whole 6 years of we expect them to know this over the 6 years, or we expect them to know to start out at this level and build on it. Or even what type of curriculum it is. Is it the core curriculum? Is it a variety of different things? And then sports offerings. There's been a lot of questions popping up in Rollinsford Facebook groups. What does the school offer for kindergartners, for first graders? Where can I find a basketball program for my first grader? Where can I find a basketball program for my third grader? And they often go unanswered. Or we get directed to check out Elliott, Maine. They have a good program. Or check out South Berwick. Check out Dover. And then you get two or three other people going, watching, wondering, and you don't know where to send your kids for sports once they finish the PV. And like I said, I don't know if you have any connections or bearing on those items.
Thank you for all those comments. And we don't have a lot of connections with some of those. They're not part of school programs, but thank you for your comments, Celia. Yep. Other Is there comments? Board closing comments?
Just something. It's just a suggestion. Before I did this, I coached Kayla's basketball, and then I know Joe coached kids as well. The sports, I think, really has to come from the parents. This has been something historically that the parents have helped to organize. And I know that in the past there's been some real good, you know, work between the board and you know, parent groups to get these things going. I absolutely encourage, especially at that age, you know, second, third graders, you know, to start getting involved in school sports, because when they get over to, you know, middle school and high school, that's what they'll want to do. And it really should start here. But I really think now it's the parents need to sort of get together on that, because you're going to need parent coaches. You know, if the coaches don't just magically appear, the folks that are have to run the program would have to be parents. And it's a great thing for kids. I know personally, I absolutely think it was one of the best things that we had here a few years ago. And I know it's involved, but it's, you know, extremely doable. I mean, if you want teams to exist, you'll get them going. You'll get them going. And I mean, this is a great place to play basketball. We've had lots of great games here in the past over the years. I encourage the parents to sort of get together on that. You know, just like the, you know, some of the other parent groups do, and even in coordination with the RUC program.
And it looks like we might have someone who'd like to make a comment. And I think that's you. Yeah. Who knows what recreation might become. All right, Jody.
May I speak on that?
Yes.
I do represent the select board on the rec committee as well. We have been reaching out. We put a budget line in for basketball. We have reached out to who was supposed to be the subcommittee liaison. They said they moved on to Marshwood. I reached out to you, actually, yes. Were trying to work on it as well. There is a budget line for you.
Not for us.
Not for your parents. For the parents, for the town.
We're not getting involved. Yeah. We're just letting you talk.
But we were, but we want to help in any way possible, but I can't find that subcommittee anymore. So if you could put a blast out to start that subcommittee.
I'm going to stop this right now. Something that sounds like the school board is having things to do with gone far afield.
Yeah.
So we'll let parents talk to parents at another time, but thank you very much. I just want to make sure the school board is not in the middle of this, or has tasks to do.
Well, we do use your facilities.
I have a question along the lines. Is there a budget line for an intramural coordinator within the school budget?
Not for a coordinator. There has been in the past some sort of intramural stuff. I believe we have.
Is that still
alive? We have had trouble finding. We'll let you know. I put away all the budget stuff.
Okay.
There's an athletics.
That's for the school.
For the school.
For the school.
Yes.
Right. The teacher for the school.
Yeah.
But athletics for gym class.
No, but I think that's the girls, and I think that's what it has been used in the past.
We'll get an answer to that question for
exactly.
Next time.
Okay.
School. And let's continue with board closing comments.
No, I think I said it all.
Not for me also. Thank you all for being here this evening. We really appreciate it. Catch you all next month, perhaps. We do have non-public, so we'll have a motion to go into non-public. We will go in for discussion and negotiation.
Second.
Yes, ma'am.